This is a KGUN9 On Your Side news update.
Thank you for joining us. I'm Pat Paris. A pedestrian has died Tuesday night after being hit by a car on the north side. It happened near First Avenue and Prince. Police say a person died on scene and the driver of the car stayed and cooperated with Tucson police. First Avenue is shut down between Prince and Fort Lowell. No word on what led up to this crash. Police say a deadly shooting on Monday night all started with a basketball game at the Christ Church United Methodist on Craycroft. The victim, 29-year-old Vashawn Baker, got into a fight with an 18-year-old on the court. That 18-year-old left and went and called his father, who then came back to the court. The father, 38-year-old Paul Alvarez, shot Baker several times. Baker died. One bullet also hit a nearby parked car with a mother and a baby inside. They were not hurt. Alvarez turned himself in on Monday night. He's facing first-degree murder charges as well as two charges of endangerment. People in Maricopa County are seeking compensation related to former Sheriff Joe Arpaio. 105 people have started to file compensation claims for being illegally detained when Arpaio disobeyed a 2011 court order barring his immigration patrols. A binational labor rights organization is working to find victims in Mexico, according to the Arizona Republic. Anyone who files a claim could qualify for $500 to $10,000 in compensation under the $500,000 fund set aside by Maricopa County. That's coming from taxpayer money. Kyle Dick standing by right now. Love this weather, but there are changes ahead.
Yes, indeed. We kind of seem to be on that active storm track lately. And let's take a look at the precipitation forecast because, yeah, Pat, right now we got some pretty nice weather out there, but we do have some moisture moving in. It'll start to move in Thursday night into Friday. It'll kind of stay with us right on through the weekend. And some decent rainfall totals there, especially south of Tucson. We'll be looking at that half inch to one inch range around the metro area. I think we'll be in more of that quarter of an inch to a half inch as we head on into the weekend. And we'll see a couple of days with highs in the lower 80s, and then it's back into the 70s into next week, and overnight lows in the 50s, remaining a little bit cool and unsettled for this time of the year.
All right, Kyler, thank you. And for more news and weather updates, head to our website, KGUN9.com. Follow us on social media as well. Thanks for joining us.